In this video, let's solve one of these systems of linear equations. This particular case will turn out to have two real eigenvalues that are different. And then we'll see how to write down the general solution in terms of our eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So first, let's write this system as a matrix equation. So we have d dt of a column vector x1, x2 is equal to the matrix. The first row of the matrix is the first equation, so 1, 1, x1, x2. And the second row of the matrix is the second equation, so 4, 1. Okay. We try our Onsots. So we're looking for solutions of the form x of t equals an eigenvector times e to the lambda t. And substituting into the equation gives us our eigenvalue problem, av equals lambda v. Okay, to solve that, we need to first find the two lambdas. So we have the determinant of a minus lambda I. That's equal to lambda squared minus the trace of the matrix, so minus 2 lambda, plus the determinant of the matrix is a 1 minus 4. So that should be a minus sign, minus 3. Equals 0. Okay, is that factorable? This is lambda minus 3, lambda plus 1. So we have lambda minus 3, lambda plus 1 equals 0. So we have two eigenvalues. We have lambda 1 equals minus 1, and lambda 2 equal to 3. Okay, once we get the eigenvalues, we need to find the eigenvectors. To do that, we look at each eigenvalue in turn. So if we start with lambda 1 equals minus 1, then the eigenvector comes from A minus lambda 1 I times the first eigenvector V1 equals 0. Okay, that's the equation for the eigenvector V1. So lambda 1 equals minus 1, so that means we add 1 to the diagonal elements. So this is 2, 1, 4, 2 times the first eigenvector. I like to write the first eigenvector as the first column of a 2x2 matrix. So I'll write that as V row 1, column 1, V row 2, column 1. And that's supposed to be equal to the 0 vector. Okay? As a case for all 2x2 matrices, when you compute the eigenvector, the first row is just the second row is just a multiple of the first row. So the second equation is just 2 times the first equation. So you only need one of these equations. So we get 2v11 plus v21 equals 0. And the first eigenvector then we can write as a column vector. We can put v11 equal to 1. The precise number is arbitrary because an eigenvector can always be multiplied by a constant. We have v11 equal to 1, so v21 is equal to minus 2. And that's our eigenvector associated with lambda 1 equals minus 1. Okay, that's the first eigenvector. Then we try to find the second eigenvector. So lambda 2 is equal to 3. And then we have this equation again, A minus lambda 2i times V2 equals 0. We need to now subtract 3 from the diagonal element. So from the looking at the matrix, 1 minus 3 is a minus 2, 1, and a 4, 1 minus 3 again is a minus 2, times V2, here I'll write that as row 1, column 2, row 2, column 2, equals 0. Again, the second row is just minus 2 times the first row, so you only need the first row. We have minus 2 V1, 2, plus V2, 2, equals 0. And we get the second eigenvector here. Again, we can take V12 equal to 1, and then V22 is equal to 2 times 1, or 2. Okay, so we have our two eigenvalues and our two eigenvectors. What is the general solution? We can use the principle of superposition. So x of t equals v e to the lambda t. So we have two solutions, v1 e to the lambda 1 t and v2 e to the lambda 2 t. So we can write x of t, right, is equal to a constant times v1. So c1 times 1 minus 2 times e to the lambda 1 t, e to the minus t, plus C2, a second constant, times V2, which is 1, 2, times E to the 3T. Okay? And that becomes our general solution. If you like, you can write that out. There's really no purpose to do that, but maybe just so you see it better. Our x1 here, then, is equal to just the first row, c1 times e to the minus t plus c2 times e to the 3t. And our x2 is equal to just the second row, minus 2c1 times e to the minus t plus 2c2 times e to the 3t. The same solution, right? Just written out component by component. Okay, so let me review what I did. We're considering a case of two first-order linear homogeneous differential equations where the roots of the characteristic equation are real and distinct. That's this equation. We do our Onsots, where we assume that x is equal to v e to the lambda t. Substitution into the differential equation gives us our eigenvalue problem, av equals lambda v. The characteristic equation gives us two eigenvalues, minus 1 and 3. Using those eigenvalues, we can find the corresponding eigenvectors. Lambda 1 equals minus 1 has an eigenvector 1, minus 2. Lambda 2 equals 3 has an eigenvector 1, 2. Using the principle of superposition, then, we can write down the general solution for x. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.